Also got a disconnect from the server in this morning knockout. In the middle of the KO I just went down. Can't really say what is the reason for that, because the speed test at least says it's completely fine, but OBS showed something red. Not sure, it's a bit risky to try that now. Maybe Rioter. Maybe. I can't really say. So Lars, it starts.
I muted myself because I was typing a lot and that always is a little bit loud, the
Ja.
mic near my keyboard. I hope it worked that I muted myself.
Ja. So what did you write?
Well, in general, I would like to know how you would go about that if, like, in general, if votes are not in the, like, similar. Let's say, two people have the exact same votes, pretty much. They have the exact same feeling, like, track by track, in what kind of order they would go. Like, from first place to last place and so on. They have them all in the same order. But one has them going from like 1 to 7, or yeah, 1 to 7, for example. And the other one has them go or has his votes ranging from 6 to 10. That's massively different votes, even though the feelings or like the ranking would still be the same in that case. But in the grand scheme of things, if there are more voters than that, the one who has a bigger depressant, how do you call that, distance between the votes, like from 1 to 7, that would be 6, and against the 4 that the other guy had from 6 to 10. So his votes would in general, yeah, be a little bit more important in the whole grand scheme of things. Like, what would be your solution for that? Because the thing that you brought up there, let's say it on the opposite path, Akili had also built a map, and let's say he voted them all pretty good. Like, he actually did that, like, most of his votes were between 6 and 10. Or 6 and. No, not 6 and 10. Actually, all of his votes were, I think, between 5 and 8, to be honest, if I recall correctly. Yeah, they were just simply that close. And let's say Red also voted like me, so a little bit more negatively, a little bit more critically. And let's say we still voted for his map well. Like, for example, I gave it one of the best spots, and Red did the same. If they were if it was a better map in that case. But Akili couldn't vote for it, so it would get still in the in the grand scheme of things, like by ranking it would be at the top, but because it doesn't get the good votes from Akili in that case, because he can't vote for his own map, he wouldn't get the good votes from that, and then in that case it would be kinda bad for himself because he was voting. So he would give himself less points because of that, or worse chance of winning.
But yeah, that's the reason why map authors shouldn't vote, usually.
Yeah, but there the problem was simply because, well, there was a big need of
voters. Yeah, that's the problem.
They wanted to do it with MX mods, and like half of the MX mods that would actually vote also build a map, so that's the problem in that case.
Yeah, that's that is the problem right now. We just had no judges, but it was not the best solution still.
I think still, like, you brought up that your and Ivo's map would be at the top.
Yeah, that was an example.
Yeah,
I mean,
I also wrote that underneath because in that case, your map would have at exactly 0.1 points more than my map, and also the map by, what do you call it, Deska. And it would have 0.3 points more than Luke's map. So in that case, you would see like they were so close to each other that the points gap would be so little. There was kind of a need for a third judge either way.
Well, in the end, it still feels a bit rigged, the results. Because it's kind of obvious that with this system, it helped your map, of course, a lot. I mean, you pushed basically all the other maps down. That is okay, your votes are okay, the points that you give are okay, but in this system with only three judges, it has a really big effect that really helps only your map in the end.
And you could also see, like, yeah, that's also the thing that I brought up. You can, at one, on the one hand, you can say that it was me that gave worse points and that it's because that, or the other judges just gave too many points. And you could also frame it on that. That's the exact same in that case. And there was the idea of, like I just brought that up, the idea of just leveling out all of the votes. And for example, my best score in flow was a 7 for Lux map, and then you would just change that one to a 10, and my worst score would go to a 0. That way you could get that a little bit more accurate, maybe, if you want to say that, but like in that case, you wouldn't have these problems as much, because then all votes would be a little bit more,
yeah, would be in the end a bit better, but of course difficult. Yeah, would take some time to.
Yeah, that's one problem, but it's not really that big. For me, rather the problem is.
Wow, Kubice is on the server.
Yeah. For me, rather the problem is there that. Let's take that same example again, about flow on Lux map. I gave it a 7. There were a few parts that I like. It's in general good. I think a 7 is a good score, a pretty good score, to be honest, especially for a 90 NPC map. And I completely drifted around the outside there. Ah. I was in the front. Could have maybe won this track. But yeah, what I was gonna say is that I have a few problems with the flow in Lux map, and I gave it a 7 for a reason. And if that would just be changed to a 10, I wouldn't be really comfortable with that, to be honest. Because from my internal voting, that would be unfair to give that map a 10, even though comparing it to other maps, it doesn't really deserve it, in my opinion. Like, it's a good score. Again, I liked it, I gave it a 7 because of that, but it has problems, so I wouldn't want it to be a 10 in that case. Same could be for other other authors who give always like pretty high scores. It could be that like a 5 on some track would need to be converted to a 0. And that would also kind of stink in that case. It would also be really not be nice if they are those kind of people that always want to give good votes and think or like every track. For example, Ibo, he loves every single track pretty much. And he probably wouldn't give less than 5 points most of the time, I would guess. And then I wouldn't think he would be fine if like a 5 from his votes would just turn into a 0 in that case. Like, I would be fine, I give zeros, but I don't think he would, for example. So that would also be a problem in that case. And also, you couldn't compare tracks between different editions. That would be impossible as well. Another problem that I see there is which was my last problem? Let me just check. Example pretty much. When I vote these tracks, I vote them on the basis as if they were monthly tech contest tracks. That you had unlimited time for them, as much time as you wanted, that the 90 minutes rule didn't exist. Because I think I can give more accurate and more objective votes if I judge them like that. And other people would like to say, for example, this map has a few mistakes, or that is a little bit sloppy, but he only had 90 minutes, he probably didn't have time to do that. Like, you could complain that there is no media tracker in a 90 MC, and like, sure, there probably isn't, but maybe some people wouldn't want to factor that in that case. Because it's 90 minutes, or like some mistake in the scenery, for example, Luke just had two platform blocks just sticking around in the outside of the scenery, and they didn't do anything there. They were completely alone there, they weren't coherent to the rest of the scenery and didn't fit there. He placed these blocks to reach the display count, which was necessary. But yeah, that's a mistake, and it's understandable if you look at it in the way that he only had 90 minutes. But I wouldn't want to just ignore that, but other people would, and that's completely understandable in my opinion. But obviously, you're gonna get completely different results in that case. I vote for these maps as if they were, yeah, maps that you had unlimited time on, and other people vote them under the notion that you only had 90 minutes. Of course, you will get completely different results, and I don't think that should be like forced, because it could be really awkward. Like, if someone would tell me I need to rate these maps at the notion that they are 90 minutes maps, and that I should see over things or disregard like mistakes because yeah, it was 90 minutes. Like I would have a problem with that probably. So I don't think that's a good solution either in that case. And like otherwise you were saying that the resides, if you would factor out my votes, that the resides would be that your map and Ibo's map would be at the top, but like if I had voted for my own map with my judging style and also how important the theme was for me and also the scenery, probably like I would probably have would have gave my map like a 7, maybe 6, 7, somewhere around there, somewhere around the same points as Deska's. I don't think my map was really that good, but I think I would have still gave it like at least a top 2 spot in my votes.
Yeah, but if I had voted, then my map would be higher maybe, so...
Yeah, so... It's just a thing, if you would just find someone else who has the exact same voting style as me, it would have come out the same way in that case. So, I don't know, that's not really... I don't think in that case it would have affected the results really.
So Yulu is not live, right?
Oh yeah, it is. Wondering why why he's even here spectating in that case.
No, I think he's not spectating anymore. I watched through top, didn't find him. This was the final map this morning. And we just, and the map before was the top 3 map. So they come again, right behind each other. Pretty interesting, top 3 and final map directly behind.
But top 4 was different?
What was the top 4 map? It was definitely another one, but can't really remember which one. Ah, oh, Firestorm didn't beat it. Oh, well. No, he didn't. Wow, it's knockout round 6 and we are only 22 players. That went quick. By the way, is the stream kind of laggy or is it smooth? Because I'm currently not really sure. The upload rate in the speed test says it should be very nice. But it feels a bit like a small internet lag sometimes. So. And I got this disconnect before the knockout started. So just want to be sure. Oops. Left, 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 left. Ah. Looks smooth. That's nice.
This one looks actually a little bit more difficult. Maybe I shouldn't have skipped the warm up. I saw one jump where you had to jump to the left, but I couldn't really see where to aim to. That looked kind of blind from above in Camp 7.
So you're to the left.
Yeah. Yeah, you have a lot of time here, it's not really a problem. I didn't see anything of this track and only second behind actually, wow. Kinda crashed as well.
Oh, Tor can't make this jump. Probably anyway out, but still. Taxon, 20th. We still have multiple knockouts. Might be the rip for Taxon. Yeah, Taxon and Tor. And Sozi. Any idea why Riolu didn't rate me? He didn't answer anything on my Discord message.
He hosted a Ville who was casting a Shitmania tournament, which isn't that, which is kind of rare, I think.
Mm-hmm.
So, and he was himself interested in that tournament, so.
Ah, okay.
I think he watched a little bit of it himself, so that makes sense. Whereas with your tournament, he probably doesn't really have any idea what it is. You also started streaming before, after he did, so I think right around that area.
I don't really know how much internet I. From my data volume I lost today. I was all the time questioning myself, what should I stream and what can I probably better just record. Usually I start Saturdays with streaming in the morning because yeah, I'm the only one that goes live at that time. So it makes sense somehow. But then I heard this Man vs Man is coming up. And Riolu went live ultra early. And then I got asked to also cast one man versus man match, which I did. And yeah, for these French guys, I said to them, I said, if my internet is good enough, I will stream the French competition there, this Royale Cup. But streaming so many hours and also streaming all the time between the matches, yeah, this is what really costs a lot of internet in the end. So I was close to saying, maybe I should just record it, because Ryulu was also live with the man versus man. This competition was parallel. If that would not have been parallel, then I think I would have had like 50 or 60 viewers the whole day. But that was not the case, of course. So I was a bit asking myself, should I really cast this now, stream it, or better record it, so I save some internet, because I just record the matches and not the whole time in between. But then there was this little hope, maybe if man versus man ends before that French Cup ends, maybe I get a raid. And that's was one of the few reasons why I said, nah, come on, I keep streaming. And then I hoped a little bit for this raid. Oh, René, welcome. Welcome, welcome. How's it going? Do you know actually that Fabian is in Braunschweig visiting Susi? And do you know that we, Fabian, Susi and me, we will go to the Netherlands in 2 weeks to a park with roller coasters and so on. Will be the first time roller coasters for Susi, and I also didn't do it a lot, especially not big ones. I drove roller coasters already, but yeah, nothing too special, I would say. I can already assume that this will be crazy. By the way, I'm currently playing knockout competition with Lars. It's just about not getting last in the live rounds.
Didn't warm up on this track as well, and there was just one part where I almost went wrong. Wanted to stay driving left, but was going to the right. There wasn't time in that part, so it almost got me.
You all have too much time. Well, during the week I don't have that much time at the moment. I use the weekend when I don't drive to Leipzig or something over the weekend, then yeah. I'm kind of alone here for the whole weekend, and then I have some time. But I also have to learn some stuff over the weekend. I'm gonna do that tomorrow a bit. Top 15 already in round 9. This is how I like it. somehow it doesn't really feel smooth. I mean, it doesn't lag, but it feels like little internet lags. A bit faster, a bit slower here and there. I don't know why, though. Maybe it's just imagination, but... it feels a bit weird. The TMX knockout from yesterday, what I recorded, the whole VOD is 5 gigabytes big. I don't believe that I can upload it before the end of this month. I think 5 gigabytes is too much for the data volume.
How long was it actually then?
Yeah, the first knockout went like 2 hours, and then the second knockout 1 more hour. It was crazy.
Way too long, they have to do something there. As you hear, again typing something, and I joined like with 5 seconds to spare.
What are you doing in the warm up?
Ibo, when I he asked something as well in the 90NC chat, and when I'm done answering with that, when I have my argument full, then I'm gonna ask you the same question. Actually, like, my time is kinda decent for the fact that I only had 5 seconds in the warm-up and just didn't see anything of it.
I drove an 89.
That's nice.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, without warm-up, pretty decent. There were some blind parts where you probably guessed correct.
Yeah, I guess. There are signs most of the time. Like, I saw signs at least.
So
I can see these down arrows on, like these dark down arrows being a little bit hard to spot.
It gets interesting now, slowly but surely. Solide Zehond and Vertex went out. Don't know this map though.
You don't know it, well, maybe I should check it out then. I know it, but I think I know it at least. Oh, Nesca. Maybe I should. One's a little bit more tricky than the others because it's way harder to see what's coming up here and how big the turns actually are. Like for Nesca, it's really important that's what kind of magnitude the left or right turns are, because normally you would always go by normally it's either one of these just simple 90 degree corners. Like the very simple 90 degree corners, which are easy to spot, of course. Just one block 90 degree corners, I mean, or the 2x2 blocks. Otherwise, like in normal tech or speed tech, stuff like that, the normal bouts, only these two are used, and then it's very easy to spot which one it is. But here in NASCAR, like if it's 4x4 or 5x5, kinda difficult to spot in my opinion.
Yeah, released way too much there.
Me too. I'm in general releasing way too much. Not sure just how lethal the end signs here are. You're gonna get a drift.
Sometimes, I think.
Yeah, I'm avoiding them by a lot.
Yeah, me too. Oh, is it Keisler? Yeah, Keisler going out. And someone else as well. Rin. seeing this track, I had some idea for a TTC map pack. Not sure if I will ever do it, but I thought about also building a mixed TTC. But without any single of the typical styles that you have usually in mixed TTCs. Every style is something new or special or own, where you don't have a complete TTC yet of that style. And grass tech was one of the ideas, of course.
Only 30 seconds again. I can need way too long to type. Because every time I go back to typing, I first need to read what I just wrote beforehand so that I know from where I'm starting again. Or where I was. And this is actually not a bit. I should definitely check this out. Okay. Yeah, this could have been the kid if I didn't look at it. Like in United, I couldn't have looked at the track now. Because I couldn't have camp 7th in the end of the warm-up. Would just fly away. How many are we?
11. Oh, first.
Yeah, I hope it's only one knockout.
No, it's two. You're out. Each top 10 players. It gets one more KO. Hmm. So it's the last round with two knockouts.
Yeah, great. I gotta save the replay because I have no idea why I touched there. Like actually no idea. I felt like I was very far away from the wall, but I just suddenly got slowed down. Should have checked that. That's kind of weird, because like touching on grass there in the tight section. Oh, that was actually the one before the little jump in between.
Yeah, I know where.
Lost a lot of time there.
Here, the map where I had a final versus Voyager once. Well, I was kind of lucky that he made a mistake.
Okay, I touched twice actually, but yeah. No, I'm not touching, but I get slowed down. Like the wheel is like one pixel away from the wall, but I'm not touching it. Yeah, great. And because I didn't notice that, I directly touched again, and because I was too inside in that, because of that, in that turn. Then I was suddenly last.
Yeah, it costs a lot of time there.
And like
basically the longest straight of the map.
Yeah. And like the end that I didn't train was the best in that case. Like I drove that part already, but yeah, that sucks. Good thing that I saved the replay. Like you always have that kind of feeling if it's like suddenly a touch or something and you think it wasn't correct or something. It's really nice to actually see the replay in that case. Because like after all like the time that you spent in this game and how long you play it and then just like touching out of nowhere. So weird. Like, it feels off just when you play a game for like, I don't know, 6-7 years or something. And well, in this case, and like you just touch out of nowhere. It's without any reason, really. Even though you should be better than that.
Bull is out now. Ninth place. Kubais is still in. But yeah, we have a very, very good top 6, definitely. And Kubites, of course, when there is a tech map, super good as well. He's very fast learner, a very good fast learner in Stadium. I mean, Kubites doesn't know any track here for sure. For him, all the tracks are completely new, and we had lots of dirt maps, so it's pretty good from him that he's still in the mix. Need to redo the start here for sure. This is one of the many fun speed tracks by Racho. But this one has turns where I think you have to slide, like here. And here you have to angle your car in the jump. It's not easy, this track. It's a bit... It has lower speed than his other tracks. In this kind of style. You have to come through this chicane, and now you have to be right. Difficult to see the correct line here already. Oh, very safe. Okay. Fourth place. That's fine. This time it is... No. It is a table going out. Kubite survived. Pretty lucky in this case. But yeah, with Table, a pretty good player, is knocked out. He can really do some sick times, he definitely improved a lot in Stadium. But here and there he makes mistakes, not too consistent yet. Next track coming up, and yeah, this is a map we played already in the previous Stadium Knockouts a few times already. It's a shaky map. So here's a little trick. You basically break and land earlier, but this was too much. So let's do it again. This was also too much. Ugh. Okay, I shouldn't risk it. Damn it. So you land earlier, accelerate earlier, less airtime, and then you go a bit ahead. And this map is pretty short, so it does definitely pays off to do something like that. And then it's just only one more turn, this one, and it's already over. And this is a super important turn with the engine killer part. So pretty shaky map. If you fuck up this last turn, you're basically out. It's already over then. You see the gap that I get? And yeah, I saved it a lot. Third place in the end. And René, thanks a lot for the sub. I appreciate that a lot. Thanks. Koopa is now out. Survived pretty long. But yeah, the maps are not complete tech, so it's really difficult for him. Have you watched Ryulu yesterday on his birthday? A bit longer than only this, how he went out in the knockout.
I just threw my marbles in a little bit, but like for half an hour or something, but before 12 I left. He had like 850 subs or something when I left. And I saw the number again.
Did he get a lot of gifted ones, or did people sub to him on their own?
I don't know, I would guess gifted, because normal subs don't come that quickly.
I mean, I saw his Discord post, his announcement, and I was like, oof. What kind of stream was that? So gonna get tight now. Oh yeah, it's full speed, I thought already. Pretty shaky. Jinx is now out. The rest was really close together. I mean, okay, there is a gap from a Scorpion and Firestone down to myself, but then myself, Voyager, and Kocho very close together. And yeah, now we are top 5, but probably skip. Because now comes a Firestone map. He has built a lot of tracks for the knockout servers. But as long as the map author is still in, the knockout maps will be skipped. So this track is by Dideric. So we can play it. The Derek usually builds very technical and weird tracks. Ah, we played this one already in the morning. This is actually not a weird track, it's pretty drivable. This is a proper tech map. There was one turn that I saved a bit too much. Close round, but it's fine. Kocho out. Well, he is a dirt driver, mostly, and this track didn't have any dirt. Which makes this, of course, difficult for him. But yeah, he got a nose slide at one turn. He was not far behind. It was a good round by all the players. I already expected it gets tough now. Now we have really good players in the knockout remaining. Next track by Track Racer. I actually don't know it. Weird track. Oh Gott. Ah yes, okay, this ending is known, I would say. Yeah, also the pulse, I played it already, but I don't know this track very well. I never did a good run here, I guess. Voyager has crashed. Good for me. Actually, Scrappy crashed the end. But he's still in. It's also good for him. Scrappy is also some kind of guy. He takes part in a competition and he wins it. It's as easy as it can be. He takes part and he wins. Somehow. So I would say he is now the biggest favorite here. Voyager on the unlucky fourth place. But that was a sick top four lineup. But Voyager made the mistake. Oh god, now we come to a Wildcat map. Always top 3 is Wildcat. I remember when Lars always said, oh, top 3 is always Stadium. I can say top 3 is always Wildcat. Incredible. Also this morning. I think. I'm not good on this map. I remember I already played it once in a decisive round. But I think I luckily survived there. Wasn't it Riulu who went out? This map is so stupid again. Ah! I just don't like it. We will see how it will go. Yo, yo, what a round! I did my really best I've ever done on this track. What a round. Gonna save the replay. And Scrappy actually out. I thought like, if that is not enough, then I don't know, but it was close. A Gardo map and a Sea Dirt. Oof, that's a map that I don't really know. Seems kind of new to me, or like a track that you forget very easily because many tracks look similar.
I love how if ever anyone asks for a cut, if it's allowed or not, it's always directly, no, it's not allowed. Even though Bushmonkey probably doesn't even know what cut it is. Like, this isn't a cut.
Yeah, well, let's not drive it.
You have to.
GG. Firestorm not that lucky in finals at the moment. I took this turn really bad. I thought when you open your mouth you say this was not good, he's far ahead. I got a slowdown out of that uphill. Wow. Not bad. So there will be a second knockout in time attack coming up. By the way, last third knockout might be interesting for you because you don't really need any stadium skills. That was really... I have to tell you, I got last, but maybe you saw it this morning.
I saw that you got last and I also wanted to check it out, but I forgot.
Yeah, it was kind of funny. Thanks, René. Oh my god, that was so inside. Is there anyone else streaming? I'm a bit surprised about the amount of viewers, to be honest.
I know that Tuxon is also streaming, but he has 2 viewers, so...
Yeah. It's so weird that there are so many viewers when Ryulu goes live at such a time that he gets over 300 currently. And when we go live, without a raid, there happens not much. I mean, I'm happy about every viewer, but it's just...
Because, in the middle of the day, normally when there would... You would think there would be more viewers. It's somehow less. Even though, you would guess there would be... Or normally there are more viewers in the evening, but maybe they all just think, oh yeah, Riolo isn't streaming. Riolo all normally streams in the evening, so... There's no stream in the evening.
Yo, hello, Samiris.
Whereas, in the middle of the day, it's more likely that you stream, for example, or that, well, it's more your time slot, for example, or spam's time slot, so they think it's, maybe don't expect that to be a stream. I've been having a discussion with Ibo in the 90MC channel on the Mix Discord about flow and in general judging. And then I see this map by him. It's fine mostly, but there's not really anything where you can really gain time on this. It's too easy. Like, and also, like, when you enter this looping, nothing happens anymore. Like, it's, I guess, a nice jump, sure, I guess, but doesn't really add value to the track. Only really, like, the transition at the start, and then the turns afterwards are kinda easy as well.
This is such a luck map. Now I got a good time, but I can tell you, if I drive this map in the final once, I won't come close. Seems to be very random for me, the end. Oh, Firestorm is out. What?
Worst place finished?
Yeah, yeah, he finished, actually. And there is Old Bot actually... What?
Everyone just tried. Oh god. Discord, he says. And,
Well, René, I have some memes. There are some memes with me being safe meister and so on. At least. Of course, other than that, I try to keep it more without memes. More like, nah, won't say, I don't want to say professional, but I don't know another word.
Nah, I think you want to have it professional, it just doesn't always work out, of course, but I think that's your goal.
A bit more like the Frostbue.
Old bots in there, I can leave this time alone.
Also a weird track. This first right-hander is super difficult. I don't know what is the best line for it. Can't say.
Yeah, Turtle Shell just had a suggestion to fix the judging problem. Just make everyone that participated judge. That was a serious suggestion. Then Ivo says you can't force people to judge, and
Yeah, yeah, this is of, this is one thing. Then the other thing is, of course, that you have again this problem when someone takes lower points for the other maps, maybe also with the intention that he can help his own track. Because that's...
Yeah, I remember there was once the notion that if you vote, your track gets a 10 automatically.
Yeah, but then there is still the question, what is the average of points that you gave other, give other maps? Yeah, and then the lower you go for other maps, the better it is for your own track. That's just a fact. Even no, not talking about if it's correct that the others have much lower points or not, but you can use it to give your own track an advantage. That's just a fact.
But I hope that you are or aware or sure that I didn't do that in this case.
No, you didn't.
I was kinda scared of this exact thing happening when I did my votes, because after voting, like, I knew this could be the case, this could be happening, but I didn't want to change my votes because I was happy with them. I think I gave accurate votes in that case, so can't change them.
Yeah, your votes are not a problem. It's just that they have such a huge weight in this case. That was the problem. That there are no other judges that didn't build a map.
Yeah, I would like to ask you the same question that Ivo asked me. What is your definition of flow? He wanted to know that.
Yeah, this is so super difficult to say. But
you saw me every round in the warm-up going back. Just trying to figure out how you would put that in words. What is, like, this must be cuttable.
It shouldn't have random aspects. It's like, I can just always tell in examples what is not flowy.
Yeah. That's always easier. I pretty much said, like, how good the map feels to drive from turn to turn. Pretty much. And, like, parts that are weird or, like, don't fit into the track are out of nowhere, kinda. In general, don't fit really to the rest of the track, that those are most of the time unflowy. In that case, if they're weird, or also boring parts, if that's also the question, how do you define a boring part in that case? And I said pretty much parts where just nothing really happens, like nothing really important in the track. And when you would be hunting a track, you could basically just take this part out completely and you wouldn't lose any value in hunting the track, or it wouldn't really change a lot, because like when hunting you wouldn't gain or lose a lot in that part. So for me personally, when there's one part which is just not really important, like let's say a long jump or just like a straight or something, in that case it would be you wouldn't really feel that invested in that part, or you wouldn't be interested in that part just because it's not important for you when driving it. Like it could be replaced with anything and it would still be the same. So and that's just parts where when playing the track, for me personally, I just don't feel good playing the track. It's not inherently fun in that case. Like for me, flow and fun are pretty much coherent, or like go together pretty much. Which was kinda annoying in this edition for the 90MC, because there was one category flow and one category fun. And one category creativity, scenery, details, and theme. And all of them were 10 points. And like for me, fun and flow is the exact same thing pretty much. There are only a little few exceptions with like random parts or weird parts.
And here you can make your own themes. Then you just say, I take this one thing not as fun, or...
Yes, of course, but it didn't really work.
This end is so... You have that bad of an angle for this last turn. I don't like this.
I just had a really nice start and I blew it away. That's blue part.
Oh. got overtaken by a lot of players in the end, of course. Bash monkey out.
Yeah, just going through the through this again. Yeah, he brought up the problem is that some maps aren't meant to be hunted or are meant to be like Ivo maps are meant to be like fun for the first try. And I can understand that, and I guess they are or could be fun for the first try. Then they would be a little bit more interesting and like more difficult or intricate maps. Could be kind of annoying on the first try because you can't really drive it that well on the first try, of course. But then in the long run, the more complicated or detailed map would have more value, and like an easy, good on the first try map would have less value in that case. And then it's the kind of.
Did you see the chat here in game? Rin got forced to spectator mode because he cut the track.
Wow. Yeah, okay. That's like, where do you see that in general? Like, you just play this competition and a map has a super obvious cut. Nobody talks about.
And he comes from the Serator scene. So he obviously goes for it.
Yeah, he's never coming back now. Thanks. Thanks, Bushman.
This was the top 3 map and this morning's Time Attack Knockout. I was kind of lucky to get through. Table wasn't able to get a good run. There was definitely some space to beat me.
But yeah, what would you say about that? Like, mappers having different intentions, like, I would want to just build a map that is fun for the first try, fun for all kinds of players. And for example, I want to have maps that are fun for players who really want to hunt maps and really want to spend a lot of time on them. Like, it's, I don't know, it's like difficult to bring these together, these different, not sure if I could say ideologies to that, but like ideas for mapping.
Yeah.
Like, what do you think about that?
Yeah, it is something completely different. That's sometimes because this is one of the reasons why you have multiple judges.
Yeah.
So the best map covers all of that a little bit, basically.
But yeah, then it's just still the question, like, at what point are you fair to the map? Or like, I always want to be like, when I judge, I want to be fair to the map, as objective as I can, really. But like in that case, I'm never that, or I'm not that certain, to be honest, because yeah, other people have other interests, and I rate maps for different things than other people do. Like, maps that I rate badly, like I only give like a 3, for example, out of 10. Other maps that could be a 9 or 10 or something. Yeah, nice time. Wow.
Thanks. Yeah, we also played it this morning.
Did you do like all of the dirt parts? No,
no, just the start.
I guess I just lost everything in the dirt turn then. Because there's not really anything else, and you're second ahead.
Nah, there's this one street turn, it was not bad.
Yeah, I guess that was bad in my one.
So, what is this track? Must be a Wildcat map when I see this.
Not necessarily.
Ah, yeah, there's not a magnet yet.
No, I don't think.
Yeah, it's Bush Monkey. That was my other idea, Bush Monkey.
Yeah. I don't think Snake builds scenery like this.
Yeah. Really don't think
so. I wouldn't think so.
Oof. I don't like these blocks.
Like, Bush Monkey is really like someone who always like focuses his maps on just a set of objects often. Like, he just sees an object set and he just focuses his map completely on that.
Yeah. Should be a decent time, but it's getting really tough here.
One time I drove 4,000 slower and then I just drove 8,000 slower. Come on, Zuli, you see one, please? Yes, thanks.
Oof. Close one. Bit's time is really strong, I don't know where he got it. I couldn't improve a lot. Oh no, not this one. we played it this morning again, yeah, and I was speaking about my problems with it, and while I was speaking about the problems, I of course didn't get it. I mean, I didn't get a run, a decent.
I wonder, like, if you had like one of these situations with these kinda cuts, which are not really cuts but just kinda, where you just do a little bit of a different route. Like in the start, you could do a little bit different route, and on this track, for example, or that final map where there was that kinda cut in the end. If you just call those parts twigs, would you think Bush Monkey would allow those? You just don't call them cuts in the first place?
Yeah, I don't know. Are tricks allowed in future knockouts? Oh, what an improvement. Oh, I still have a run. Okay, let's go for the jump.
No. Oh, it's not a good run, but then I got a nose slide. Please, Tuxon. And he improves, of course. Just barely. I was on a good run, and then I just get a nose slide. I hate that part with that kind of jump. I don't know.
Yes, I also hate it.
If I go like, if I want to do that quickly, I get a nose. I just keep the grid lines, not grid lines, braking lines.
Basically, what I did was I didn't jump in my first tries to get something into the finish.
Yeah, I wasn't jumping either. I was never jumping. But I don't know.
In my last run, I jumped.
Did he actually survive that? I would have thought that he would jump too far in that case.
Yeah, depends on how low or high you jump.
Would have maybe been good if I jumped just a little bit and then just kept the autopilot from that.
Oh god, this is gonna be difficult now.
Yeah,
for the moment in front, but against these plays, this is not safe. The round is improvable. Oh my god, I'm third. Super close. But I have one more try. Three times the same time in the finish, basically. Ah, Taxon was still in. Okay, he went out now. That was really... I throw three times the same time. Sometimes it happens that you go out with that. Because none of these times is in the end good enough. This is a full speed track. Basically, it just... consisting out of this one wall ride and a speed slate in the end. That's unlucky for Taxon that he went out, because this is a track for him, definitely. Ah! I don't see, it's all black there. Usually I'm pretty good on this track, but I need to get something through first here. Not the best speed slide. I have one more attempt. It looks good. I'm Wager got a new local and I'm still first. Another little improvement. Oh, Voyager beats me. Bits beats me? Did he? No way. In the last sec- No! What is this? Oh my god. How unlucky can you be?
Oh, and now it's like, no, Vidarik.
This is the map that we played in the final. I would have won this, pretty sure.
This is the map that I won in the final against you, yeah. And you already have a better time here. 0.4, you have a 0.3. Or did I win or was it just close? I think I won, right?
Yeah, you won, because I drove the wrong line.
Yeah.
And lost way too much time with that. And we also played this map in the morning KO, so I'm kind of fit already. Wow, this was just the most unlucky defeat I ever had in a knockout, to be honest. Also because I know that I could improve myself still a lot. This last round was not too great, it was still fine, and it was an improvement, but it was... I could have done better. And when it looks all the time like you are pretty safe in the lead, the others were far behind in the times, and then they both beat you in bits by 1000. I mean, what? This is like nothing. Incredible. However, this is not the final, and currently we have Voyager in the lead, and Bits on his last attempt here. He needs to beat Voyager. Voyager also on the run. You see him at the top. Bits going very wide here, but he gets it. Voyager with a mistake. This is the chance for Bits, and he gets it very good, but he has to release there. It's still enough. 59 hundredths ahead of Voyager. So Bits takes it here in the last attempt. Ah, okay, this Bits time would have been difficult to beat. You got it really well.
But Voyager also didn't beat our times that we drove in that one final.
Nah, yeah, he had not a good round.
Yeah.
He just
probably knew, because Bits is decent in stadium, of course.
Currently in the knockouts, I always have a first place and a not and a podium place, and the last three podium places were always third. Which is actually perfect, because second and fourth are the two unlucky positions, so first and third is quite nice, but of course this third place hurts a bit. When we played this full speed track, I was always first when it came up. And now when it was top 3, I get third there. By so close, I mean. Yeah. So the next third knockout, which is the last one, which is more a fun knockout, not official, is super, super quick over.
I never checked that this map right here. I think you can cut the end, actually. I never tried or looked at it, but I think you can cut this end, just jump into the finish. Out of that kind of bow, there's no CP. It won't be like super much faster, but still quite faster, I think. Maybe a second.
Yeah, maybe. It's always difficult to say how high you actually jump out of that.
Yeah. How high you need to jump there. But yeah, I'm just picturing, of course, jumping into a triangle there. That would be difficult, of course. Very difficult. Maybe you can aim that a little bit. Let me try. Imagine I get that in my first try in the warm up, then it doesn't count. There's a sculpture above. I hit that. Yeah. Or maybe you could like bug slide into it. Rippler by Just a Mapper. I think I heard Just a Mapper at some point already. But I'm not sure. It's way faster, maybe 2 seconds or something.
I did it with my time.
Oh. Nice.
And it was not good.
I just saw you on the roof. But like, if you finish it, it would be good. But that's something you can buy now every time when you when we need to wait on the track.
Oh, Firestorm is back for this map.
Right. Is it a dirt map?
No. You will wonder what kind of map this is. You don't need a lot of stadium skill.
Is this like full speed but without speed slides? I don't know. Can you NASCAR these parts?
This morning I got last place on this beautiful track.
I wonder how you did that. Oh, did you try to jump left in the first lap in that jump?
Yes. I landed directly on the sign and from the sign to the platform, but clipped a bit there.
Nice brain lag.
This is not a brain lag, I would say. How could I know?
Yeah, of course you are slow in the first lap.
Yeah, but how could I know that it's too slow?
I don't know. Pretty obvious, I think. Doesn't really feel like you have a lot of speed in the first lap, to me at least.
Damn it.
Okay, I'm out. I was second, but I got a fifth. Yeah, that's just completely rip. I'm not last. Now I need to wait for the whole lap. Like, I'm still lap 3. So bad, just getting drift once. But, damn it. Wow, you caught up so much too fast, I think I could have won this.
Yeah, anyone could win here. I know, he takes the booster, it's similar fast.
Yeah.
It's similar fast. But I won't do that. I did it in the first lap. But not anymore.
You were behind me though in the first lap.
Yeah, because I'm too fast for this turn when I take all three boosters. I had to release here again. Was.
Yeah, he lost in this one. I think this line is better. I took this exact same line as you did here. Damn, I was already in front of you. Wondering though why I got a trip. I guess maybe I landed a little bit angled. I was straight and I started steering on the blue card, but maybe I landed a little bit angled. Like, just like you did right there. Like, you land a little bit angled on the speed, maybe that carried over, and that's why I drifted.
Yeah.
wo feierst du? Oh mein Gott!
Yes?
In the Knockouts channel on in the MX Discord, the results got published.
And that's wrong.
Yeah, but intentionally wrong. Because Bush Monkey says that Firestorm cut it in the final. Because...
So Firestorm is not in the top 3 anymore.
Yeah. He was like 2 seconds behind of you. And as a joke, he drove the cut and didn't even finish. And then he got disqualified because he cut it, apparently.
And who's the new second?
Crappy.
Huh. Do I want to win against Crappy or versus Firestorm?
There?
Yes. No. It was when I said Scrappy always wins.
Okay.
And then we had this Wildcat map. Decent lap. Okay. That concludes this.